Good morning, students. Welcome to English Kumar Bharti class. Children, today we'll be doing the last poem of the year from Unit 4, that is 4.5 Tansen. Dear students, you may have heard the name Tansen, the great musician our country has produced. A singer called Mukanandan Mishra and his wife lived in Behat near Gwalior. Tansen was their only child. It is said that he was a naughty child. Often he ran away to play in the forest and soon learned to imitate perfectly the calls of birds and animals. A famous singer named Swami Haridas was once traveling through the forest with his disciples. Children, here disciple means followers. Tired, the group settled down to rest in a shady grove. Tansen saw them. He hid behind a tree and roared like a tiger. The little group of travelers scattered in fear. But Swami Haridas was impressed by the skill of the boy. Swami Haridas did not punish Tansen. In fact, he went to Tansen's father and said, "Your son is very naughty, but he is also very talented. I think I can make him a good singer." Tansen was just 10 years old when he went away with Swami Haridas. He lived with him for 11 years, learning music and became a great singer. Akbar was so impressed that he asked Tansen to join his court. So children, this was the story about Tansen's childhood and his journey towards being a singer. Now the poem which is given on page number 106 of your course book, that is Tansen 4.5, has been written by the poet Hazrat Inayat Khan. Hazrat Inayat Khan was a Sufi musician who introduced the Sufi music in the West. My dear children, Sufi is a type of a music. The Nizam of Hyderabad honored him as the Tansen of his time. He spread Sufi music worldwide. He is known for his brilliance in poetry and music. Yet his deepest inner calling was in spiritual matter. Here spiritual means religious. He has received many awards and medals of honor for his magnificent singing. So this was the introduction about Hazrat Inayat Khan, who is the poet of this poem Tansen, and also I would like to tell you that this poem is a narrative poem. I mean, there is a story hidden in this poem. The poem has 23 rhyming couplets. I have explained the meaning of couplet to you before. Even before, here couplet means two lines, that is couplet, that is each line is rhyming with the other. The rhyme scheme of the poem is AA, BB, CC, and so on. We are gonna see few couplets at time and I'll explain you simultaneously. So first let us see the first three couplets, that is the first six lines. Let me read the poem, or I can say the three couplets for you. Tansen the singer in great Akbar's court, won great renown through the Badshah he fought. His voice rang like the sound of silver bells, and Akbar ravish heard, the story tells. How the king praised him, gave him many a gem, called him chief jewel in his diadem. Children, here renown means famous. Yes. Praise means to appreciate. Diadem means crown, and chief means mane. Okay. So see here, in the second couplet, it is given, the story tells means In this poem, there is a story. Let us see the explanation of these six lines. So, when Tansen was already a mature musician, or I can say, when he reached the age of 60, he joined the court of Mughal emperor, that is Emperor Akbar. Emperor Akbar was very well known for his patronage, I can say the love for the arts. Tansen became one of the Navratans, that is nine gems. Now everyone know that Emperor Akbar had nine gems, I can say Navratans, in his court. Now what do you mean by nine gems? A collection of most talented intellectuals and artists in the court. He had nine such special pupils. Okay, so I told you, you might have heard about the nine gems of Akbar. Let us take the glimpse. You all can see in this image, these are the names of the nine gems of Akbar's court. These nine gems were very extraordinary people, nine extraordinary people in Akbar's court. And one of his nine gems was Tansen. Okay, so Tansen was also one of them. And because of these nine intellectual people, Akbar was very famous. Moving back to the story, Tansen went to Akbar's court in 1556 and soon became a great favorite of Emperor Akbar. Akbar would call upon Tansen to sing at any time during the day or night. Quite often, Emperor Akbar would walk into Tansen's house to hear him practice. He also gave him many presents. He is enchanting. Here enchanting means, you know, attractive. Voice captivated, attracted the heart of Emperor Akbar. Thus, Emperor Akbar gave Tansen sufficient wealth and even referred to him as the jewel of his crown. He also called him as the main, you know, the center jewel of his crown, that is diadem. So that was the explanation of these three couplets. Let us move to the next three couplets. Let me read. One day the singer sang the song of fire, the Deepak rag, and burning like a pyre. His body burst into consuming flame. To cure his burning heart, a maiden came and sang Malhar, the song of water cold, till health return and comfort as of old. Children, here Deepak rag means a song of fire. Maiden means unmarried girl. And Malhar means a song of water. Let us see the explanation behind these three couplets. So one day what happened? Some courtyards of Akbar court were jealous of Tansen and his popularity, because Tansen was very popular. And even Emperor Akbar appreciated him a lot, or I, you know. So these members in the courtyard were jealous of Tansen, and soon they became his enemies. One day they decided to spoil his music career and thought to get rid of him forever. So they thought that we would ask Tansen to sing Deepak rag. Now what is Deepak rag? The song of fire. If Deepak rag was sung properly by Tansen, the air and the surrounding would become so hot that the singer would be burned to ashes. Whoever will sing it. Of course, now only who was the best singer? Tansen. So if Tansen will sing it properly, he himself would get burned by the heat. Shaukat Mia, a name of a courtier in Akbar's court, requested Akbar to make Tansen sing Deepak Rag. Tansen was afraid to sing Deepak Rag, but was scared to disobey Emperor's Akbar order. Besides, he also wanted to show his singing ability and talent in music, because you know, of course my life would be in danger, but the moment I'll sing and the impact it will produce, of course, will make me more popular. So he requested the king, that is Emperor Akbar, Tansen requested Emperor Akbar to allow him, or I can say give him some time to prepare for it. Emperor Akbar agreed. In that meantime, he thought of a brilliant idea. He thought of Rag Megh to teach to his daughter Saraswati and Saraswati's friend, that is Rupvati, for 2 weeks. Okay, Megh, or I can say Malhar. Megh or Malhar is same. He told his daughter Saraswati and her friend Rupvati that as soon as I complete singing Deepak Rag, they should start, these both girls should start singing Malhar, okay, that is Rag Megh, to bring rain and appease the effect of heat. Yes, the way Tansen planned, his plan worked perfectly. When he sang Deepak Rag, the surrounding became warm. The leaves of the tree dried up because of the heat of that song. Birds fell dead. Water of rivers began to boil. People were terrified that flame shot up out of nowhere and lighted the lamps. Just then, his daughter Saraswati and her friend Rupvati began to sing Rag Megh, or I can say Malhar. The sky filled with dark clouds and the rain came down suddenly, and this saved Tansen's life and the surrounding from more damages. It is said that after this incident, Tansen became sick and Akbar Emperor came to know the devil plan about his courtiers to spoil Tansen's reputation. So after knowing this, Emperor Akbar punished the courtiers. Tansen recovered from his illness and people rejoiced, that is they were happy and they celebrated his recovery. Let us see the next 7 couplets. We'll be seeing 7 couplets, that is 14 lines. Let us see. Mighty they teacher must be and divine, great Akbar said, magic indeed is thine. Learn at his feet, then happy Tansen bowed and said, beyond the world's ignoble crowd, scorning its wealth, remote and far away, he dwells within a cave of Himalay. Could I but see him once, desire the king, sit at his feet awhile and listening. Hear his celestial song, I would deny my state and walk in robes of poverty. Then said Tansen, as you desire, Huzoor, indeed to earth, better as a slave and poor. To come, for he lifted above the things, O earth, disdain to sing to earthly king. So children, let us see the explanation of these lines. One day, Emperor Akbar said to his chief singer, that is the main singer, Tansen, that you are such a great singer and there is such wonderful magic in your voice. I wonder, if you are so great, how great your teacher must have been. Please, said Tansen, never compare me with my teacher. There is no comparison of me and my teacher. Akbar then expressed his desire to know more about his teacher and also wanted him to meet Tansen's teacher, from whom Tansen had learned to sing so brilliantly. Tansen replied that his teacher lived in a Himalayan cave away from the unworthy people of the world. Since he was above all the wealth and pleasure of the world, my teacher did not interact or did not sing for wealthy men. And as you are wealthy, my dear emperor, you are a king, so it's impossible for you to meet my teacher, and he won't sing for you or for any of the worldly men. So Akbar said that he will change his kingly attire. Here attire means appearance, clothing, and he will dress as a slave. Will it be okay? On hearing this, Tansen said, as you wish, Huzoor. If you are ready to take that appearance, then I may take you to my teacher who lives in the Himalayan cave. And Emperor Akbar followed Tansen on a journey to the Himalayas. Let us see that next 7 couplets, what happened as they went. Yes. Long was the road, and Akbar as a slave followed Tansen, who rode towards the cave. High in the mountains at the singer's feet, they knelt and prayed with supplication sweet. Towards they shrine, lo, we have journeyed long. O holy master, bless us with thy song. Then Ustad, won by their humility, sang song of peace and high felicity. The Malkas Raga all ecstatic rang, till birds and beasts enchanted as he sang. Gathered to hear over Akbar's dreamy soul, he felt the waves of heavenly rapture roll. But as he turned to speak his words of praise, Ustad had vanished from his wondering gaze. Children, here vanish means to disappear. Okay, humility means humbleness. So let us see the explanation of these lines. So Akbar went, or I can say followed Tansen, and then after traveling a long journey, they found Tansen's teacher. That is Swami Haridas, which we have already seen in the introduction para, because he was the one who took Tansen along with him when Tansen was only 10 years old. Yes, we have seen this. And now this same person, that is Swami Haridas, Tansen's teacher, is living in the mountain in solitude. Solitude matlab all alone, means all alone, lonely. Although Akbar was dressed as a servant, but this sage, you know, Swami, recognized Emperor Akbar. Still with Emperor Akbar humble attitude, he was impressed. Okay, because Emperor humble attitude appealed him, and then he sang, and both Akbar and Tansen became spellbound, that is speechless. So when Ustad rendered the Malkas Raga, yes, what is Malkas Raga? The song of peace. Malkas Raga means the song of peace. Let us see what was the impact of this peaceful song when Swami Haridas, that is Tansen's teacher, started singing this song. All the birds and the animals were captivated, you know, attracted by the music, and they gathered to hear him sing. And Akbar, listening to it, felt as if his soul wasn't a musical heaven. Spear of the earth was lost from their consciousness. I mean, they became, you know, they lost their senses. They went into some another world. Who? Akbar and Tansen. Because of that melodious song, Malkas. And when they came to their senses, I mean, when the song got over and when these people came to their senses, they came back. They saw that this Swami was not there anymore. "Where is he?" Akbar asked. Tansen said that he has left this place forever. Why? Because he feared that we might come again and again and trouble him. So he has left this place forever. Akbar could not say one word in praise of the music which he had heard from Swami Haridas, that is Tansen's teacher. Now, my dear children, you know why Ustad had vanished, why he disappeared? That's because he had achieved the supreme state of spirituality. Here, spirituality means religiousness through singing. So he did not wait for any praise or a claim, you know, because he himself know that I'm here to impress my God, spiritual power, not the worldly power, that is the kings or the prince or the princess or the queens. I'm not here to, you know, please them. I'm just here to please my God, and my God is impressed by me. That's it's enough. I have got my fruit. I've achieved the supreme state. That's what he is trying to convey. My dear children, let me tell you about Malkas Raga. Malkas Raga is believed to have been created by Goddess Saraswati to calm Lord Shiva. When Lord Shiva was outraged and not coming down after thunder in the rage of Sati sacrifice, this Malkas Raga presents a feeling of sense of conquering the self and reaching a state of inner satisfaction. So this peaceful song is sung. Okay, let us move to the last three couplets. I'll read out. "Tell me, Tansen, what theme this is that holds the soul enchanted and the heart unfold in high delight? And when he knew the name, 'Tell me again,' he said, 'Could you the same theme sing to lure my heart to path untrod? Ah, no, to thee I sing,' he sings to God." Written by Hazrat Inayat Khan. So let us see what these couplets tell us. Now, when Akbar was satisfied and when he returned back to his palace, some days after, or I can say some weeks later, he called Tansen before him and asked him to sing the same Malkas Rag that Swami Haridas had sung that day when they went to the Himalayan cave. Tansen obliged and sang. When the song was over, Akbar looked at Tansen and said, "It is true that is the rag your teacher sang is different than what you sang." Ah, said Tansen, "Yes, I agree. The one what my teacher sang that day and the one which I sang today is quite different. You know why? Because I stand here and sing for you, that is the emperor, the worldly king, and you give me money in return. That means I sell my skill. And that day what my teacher sang was for the God, and he doesn't take anything from my God. And that's the difference, that my Malkas Rag singing is quite different from my teacher's singing. And so I told you, please never compare me and my teacher, because here I am to praise, or I can say to please you, and there my teacher is to please the Almighty, that is God." And that was all about the poem, my dear children, and that's the story behind it. I hope you have followed the poem, and with this the poems get over, and even the portion for this year gets over. I hope you have followed it. Thank you. That was for today.